Another way we look at this is as we progress in the learning of that skill, we reach this place where we really have to ask ourselves, my inability to perform this particular function, is it a matter of my will or is it a matter of the lack of my skill? It's the Well, thanks for tuning in to the broadcast today. My name is D.A. Williams, and you are watching The Conceptual Change. You know, I actually love being able to come into your home and just share these broadcasts with you and, you know, try to inspire you to move to that next dimension in your life and inspire you to approach life's challenges and life's obstacles from a different perspective. And one of the things that I really appreciate is that a lot of the things that I share on the broadcast, I really do realize that it's not just theory. My perspective on anything, whether we're talking philosophy, if we're talking psychology, if we're talking religious faiths, whatever discipline we are actually looking at, I am discovering that it is really of no value if it isn't something that we can make practical in our day-to-day lives, if it isn't something that we can learn to apply in a consistent and conscientious way that's actually going to produce the results that we desire in life. And I simply want to share things that I have discovered in my own life. They work. I have been involved with self-discovery, self-help, different transformation techniques for well over 30 years. I've explored a lot. I've learned a lot. I've made a lot of mistakes. I've learned from my mistakes as well. You know, I'm thinking about Einstein and his invention of the light bulb. It has been said that Einstein failed so many different times trying to invent the light bulb. And I'm just going to use the number of 199. And Einstein was actually asked, how can you continue to attempt to build something when you have failed so many times? And Einstein's reply to that was, I have not failed 199 times trying to discover the light bulb. I have actually found 199 different ways that don't work. Now, that's a very powerful shift in your thinking. When you say, you know, these seeming failures really aren't failures. It's actually feedback. And that is one of the tenets. It's one of the presuppositions that I choose to live by. And that is that there is no such thing as failure. There's only feedback. You know, so as we are seeking to learn new skills, whether we are seeking to develop new ways of relationships, if we are placed in a situation where we have to learn new skill sets on the job, you know, looking at it as there is no such thing as failure. I'm only getting feedback as I learn these new skills and as I learn these new techniques. And that's what I want to focus on the broadcast tonight, today. I want to actually talk about something that is known in the NLP circles, NLP being neuro-linguistic programming, which we'll explore a little further in some later broadcasts. But one of the things they use, it's called the four stages of competence or the conscious competence learning model. Now, that may sound, you know, like a lot to grasp, but by the end of the broadcast, you're going to understand exactly how to implement these processes and understand these different stages of learning. And once you understand these different stages of learning, you will approach your learning from a total different perspective. And as we go through each of these steps, we're going to talk about some of the hindrances in some of the steps, as well as the successes that can be learned in those particular steps. So as I said, it's known as the conscious competence learning model, and it relates to the psychological states that are involved in the learning process. You see, our psychology, our attitudes, the way that we look at things, the way that we perceive different learning experiences has a lot to do with what we take away from the learning. I learned that in a very real way this week as I was presenting some new material to a group of agents within one of the Fortune 500, they're probably Fortune 100 companies. And I was teaching some skills to shift them into another type of career. The place was actually doing one particular type of work. They've become a different kind of department, and as a result, all of the employees have to go through retraining. So they're learning different skill sets to perform a different function within the same organization. And I realized immediately that one of the main hurdles that would have to be, you know, that would have to be overcome in this particular situation didn't have to do so much with the material that's being presented, but it had to do with the shifting of the mindset of those who were going to learn the material. Now, stay with me on this. These four stages of learning will apply to learning any new skill at all. These four stages of learning also provide a model that you can use to understand your progress. You know, you want to be able to measure your success. You want to measure your progress. You want to measure exactly where you are in relationship to where you're trying to get. This particular learning model will help you do just that. So let's explore this model. And that first stage of the competence learning model is what we can define as unconscious incompetence. So let me say it again. It's unconscious incompetence. And in this stage, the learner is totally unaware not only of the skill that they're going to learn, but they're totally unaware that they don't know this skill. You know, it's something new. It's totally out of their particular framework. They are unconsciously incompetent. And in this stage is where, you know, individuals may not really understand the benefit of the new skill. They may not know or accept the usefulness of the new skill. And they're totally unaware and unconscious of how incompetent they are with this particular skill, because they don't even know that the skill exists, number one. And number two, being unaware that the skill doesn't exist, they're unaware of the benefit that this skill can actually present to them. Now, the length of time, and this is important, because the length of time that individuals remain in this first stage of unconscious incompetence depends solely on the learner. So it's not a case of, you know, the instructor, the facilitator, the trainer, the teacher, whatever the situation may be. But the length of time that an individual stays within that stage has to do with the learner, and it also has to do with the stimulation or the strength of the will to learn the new skill. Another way we look at this is as we progress in the learning of that skill, we reach this place where we really have to ask ourselves, my inability to perform this particular function, is it a matter of my will or is it a matter of the lack of my skill? It's the will versus skill scenario. And in a lot of cases, I'm finding it's not a matter of not knowing the skill. It's a matter of not having the will to learn the skill or to become efficient in the skill. This is that stage of unconscious incompetence. So the sooner a person can get through that stage and recognize, yes, this is a new skill, I'm totally incompetent in it, I don't know anything about it, I don't know how to perform it, but I see the benefit of it, and I am opening myself up to the experience of learning how to do it. Once an individual reaches that place, something actually happens internally. There's a shift emotionally as well as a shift in the attitude for them to receive the new information and begin to apply the things that are needed to become competent in that particular field. Now, the second stage that the person moves into is known as conscious incompetence. So at this stage, the individual may not understand or know how to perform something. They recognize their inability to do it. And they also recognize the value of the skill in terms of addressing their own deficit in not knowing how to perform the skill. It's at this stage that as they're making mistakes, those mistakes become integral to the learning process. Now, I don't know anyone who has learned a new skill and hasn't made mistakes in learning it. It's new. Mistakes are natural when you're learning something new. So because you're not a master at that particular field overnight, don't allow that to discourage you. Recognize that the mistakes that you're making are actually learning tools that you can apply because they become feedback on how not to perform that particular skill. And that's why I'm saying a lot of this has to do with a radical shift in a person's attitude as they're attempting to learn new skills. So they have moved out of the place of unconscious incompetence to being conscious of their incompetence. So in the first stage, they didn't know what they didn't know. In this stage, they know what they don't know. Do you see what's happening? They're actually growing. They're actually developing. They're progressing. They are on their way to becoming competent in that particular skill. Now, once you move past that skill, you move into the area of conscious competence. So you go from unconscious incompetence to conscious incompetence, and then you move into the area of being conscious of your competency. It's at this stage that you understand and you know how to do something. You have learned this new skill. You're conscious that you can do the skill. It's also at this stage where you begin to become confident in what you're doing. So it's no longer so much of a struggle to perform the task. It's much easier to do, but you still have to focus a lot of attention in performing it. You know the steps, you know the stages, you know the processes, and you follow those stages and those processes because you have learned them. So this still requires a lot of concentration to perform that particular function. You can break it down into steps, and there can be a lot of conscious involvement in you doing it. Now, here's a good example. When you think about driving a car or learning how to drive a car, you know, as I already said, I like to make things practical. When you learn how to drive a car, at some stage in your life, you were unconscious and incompetent when it pertained to driving a car. You know, you may have been a baby, you may have been much younger, you weren't even thinking about learning how to drive. But the older you get, you begin to realize, I want to learn how to drive. And so you begin to take driver lessons. Is at this stage, you now begin to understand how incompetent at driving you actually are. You don't know to put your foot on the brake at certain times. You know, you don't know to look to the left or to the right as you're moving. You don't know what the stop signs mean. There's a lot of things that you're learning. And so even when you were learning how to drive, depending on who taught you, the man said, okay, well, slow down. You know, you can't make a left turn in the right-hand lane. You learn the different rules of driving. And you know, as you're doing that, you make mistakes. You know, some people, you know, even after getting a driver's license makes mistakes, but that's a different issue. You know, they end up getting tickets and all of that good stuff like that. But, you know, you become conscious of your incompetency. Then you actually arrive at the place where you are consciously competent of driving, and so now you're ready to go take your driver's license exam. And you are very conscious while you're taking that exam of following the rules, of following the processes, of following the procedures of operating a motor vehicle. And you get your license. You're conscious of it. All right. So that's a practical application of what we're talking about. Now, the next stage that you arrive at is called unconscious competence. It's at this stage that you have had so much practice with this skill, it almost becomes second nature. You don't even think about it anymore. You know, when you go out and you get in your car and you're trying to drive to reach your destination, you know, you can get in the car while you're talking on your phone, you know, you're singing, you're thinking about what you're going to have to do when you get to school or you get to work, you know, you get in the car, you put your seatbelt on, you put the key in the ignition, you turn on the radio, you know, you back up and you're just driving. And as I talked about on one of the earlier broadcasts, many people begin to go into driver's trance. That's when you're driving to a destination. You're totally focused on something else. You arrive at your destination and you don't even remember the drive. You know, you forget what was around you because you were deep in thought about something else. You're planning out your day. You're preparing for that meeting or you were thinking about that date that you're going on. You know, but you drove to the destination and you actually arrived safely. No accidents. How is it possible to drive from one destination to another destination and not be focused on just simply driving? You are unconsciously competent now. So in a way, it's second nature, and really your subconscious has kicked in and it's paying attention. So you are paying attention, hopefully. But things are happening on the inside. You're not thinking about all of the rules, all of the this, all of the that. You're simply doing the skill. And those are the stages that we go through with any kind of new learning. We start out, we don't know anything about it. We don't know that we don't know anything about it because we're unfamiliar with it. Someone introduces it to us, or we're put in a situation where we have to learn something. And as we begin to learn, we recognize that we are consciously incompetent at that skill. Now, the challenge is at this place that many people begin to shut down. I mean, they literally shut down from the learning experience. And they make a lot of excuses as to why they're shutting down. I'm too old for this. I can't learn this. I can't do this. Something's wrong with the material. Something's wrong with the processes. They make all types of excuses because they have literally shut down their own, really, they have shut off the learning mechanisms of their brain. You know, they're just tuned out and turned off. And they get stuck in that state, and it's in that state that they stay. They never grow. They never develop. They never learn new skills. They never learn new ways of doing anything. And so I'm presenting this model simply to encourage you that, as you know, not just as we're going through these broadcasts from week to week, but just in your daily life, you know, when it comes time for you to learn something new, or even if you have the desire to learn something new, don't get discouraged in the learning process. Mistakes will be made. Remember, there's no such thing as failure. There is only feedback. And take that feedback, take those learnings, take those mistakes, you know, and just recognize, okay, well, it didn't work this way. Let me try it a different way. It's often said, if you want to keep getting what you're getting, just keep doing what you're doing. So if you want to change what you're getting out of life, you are going to have to learn to do some new things. And as you are doing new things, you are going to go through these stages. And so I trust that, you know, you can go back and, you know, hopefully you were taking some notes on the broadcast. If you'd like additional information about this conscious competence ladder, I'll be more than happy to send you some information. We have some nice diagrams that lay it out. We have some nice some PowerPoint presentations that you can go through, because I want to encourage you to embrace the changes that are coming your way. Everything in life changes. Situations change, circumstances change, relationships change. We are presented new information every day. You know, there are changes happening everywhere. And I tell people all of the time, don't fight the change process, because you can't win. You are going to change. So learn to work with change. Learn to embrace change. Because the learners will always find themselves creating the world of tomorrow. The learned find themselves living in a world that no longer exists. I want to encourage you, stay a learner. Always be willing to learn new things. Be willing to make mistakes. Be willing to fail in some ventures, knowing that there really is no such thing as failure. There is only feedback. You are going to fall. Just make sure that when you fall forward and not backward. That way you will always guarantee that you're making advances in your life. Well, again, I am so thankful that you allowed me to come into your home via this broadcast and share this information with you. In just a moment, we're going to give you our contact information. I want you to be sure to drop us an email. Visit us online at our website, transformedmind.com. Visit our Facebook page. You'll find us on Facebook. All of that information is available. Twitter. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel as well. There's a lot of teaching information there that was done previously. If you own a business, if you are an entrepreneur, and you would like for us to come in and do some workshops on sales, some workshops on team building, contact us. We'll be more than happy to talk to you and discuss how we can set those things up. And as I always say every week, always be sure to stay motivated, stay inspired, always be a learner. You have a great week. Bye-bye.